Hello. Welcome or welcome back. I know it's been a minute if you're coming back. If you're new here, hi, my name is Natasha. I do organizing and cleaning videos. I am pretty new to YouTube, but I've already taken an unintentional, like, couple month break. So in this video, it's just a deep clean. I'm going to be deep cleaning those couches, deep cleaning the front bathroom, getting behind the fridge, getting behind the stove, just some basic spring cleaning. I actually clean behind the fridge and the stove more than once a year though. But yeah, if you are joining for the first time, welcome. Like I said, I do cleaning and organizing videos and really just whatever I feel like doing, I guess. But I did take a really long break, and so I'm glad I'm finally here doing the voiceover for this video. This video was actually recorded probably a few months ago, but thank you so much for being here, and I hope you enjoy this. Obviously, these couches are white, cream, whatever. They're light colored, so they pick up everything. They're always dirty, and there's a lot of kids in this house, so there's always stains. Stuff is always getting spilt on them. But I have taken off the cushion covers before and just thrown them in the washer, and yes, that is super easy to do, but I feel like they're starting to... not, I don't want to say fall apart, but they are like coming apart on the inside. And so taking them off isn't really as easy. And I'm just worried that they're going to fall apart. I'm not going to be able to put them back on. I don't know. Whatever. I actually do enjoy using this carpet cleaner. It's Bissell, the Pet Pro Pro Heat. I'll have it linked in the description. I love this thing. Yeah, I use it. That carpet down there, I carpet clean that at least once a week, actually. I love doing it, but that carpet down there is also light colored and it just looks so much better. And once a week, cleaning it really does like make the difference. And so with the couches, I mean, if I can do it once a week, but that's not always easy to squeeze that in, like doing the whole couch like this. But actually, now that I'm doing the voiceover for this video, they actually need to be cleaned again. So yeah, but I do take the covers off the pillows and I get those washed in the washer, and all the little blankets, I'm gonna get everything washed. Thank you. So every time I use my carpet cleaner, I just use laundry detergent. Sometimes I might throw some vinegar in there or even a little bit of Dawn dish soap, but I also like to use the Dawn power spray if I have like trouble stains or if I'm having trouble getting something out. It usually just helps to lift those stains, and it's also really good on the walls for like crayon or even pen. I've gotten pen marks off the wall with it. But yeah, I just use laundry soap, and lately I've just been throwing an entire Tide Pod inside the like water reservoir on the carpet cleaner. Works amazing, and it smells so good in here after I use it. I go to empty this out and come back, and womp womp, it's broken. I don't know how. I think maybe when I set it down, I think it fell and hit the ground too hard. But yeah, I have replaced it. I got like a $10 replacement on Amazon, and it's actually better than the one that I had. It has like three rows of those brushes, those bristle brushes on there, and I don't know. I just like the way it sucks it up or whatever. I like the way it vacuums better. And so that was my daughter, Helena. She's just helping me pick up around the living room so that way I can just get started on this carpet and just look at how satisfying that is. Like, I actually enjoy doing this once a week. So since recording this video, I have actually gotten my butt back in the gym. I've been going to the gym now, I guess, for about 3 weeks. And I have actually been low carb for over a month now. So I guess that's about how long it's been since I even recorded this video and the little break that I've taken. So I just decided to really just get into keto. This would be the second time I've ever done keto. The first time was like 3 years ago or so when it was like really popular. And I did see like some weight loss and everything, but I was in the gym like every single day at that time. And a lot's happened since then, but I decided to do it again because I wanted to try and get the most out of keto, all of the benefits that are supposed to come with keto. If you don't already know about keto, I mean, look it up and do your own research, because I'm not here to try to convince anybody to do anything, but it's just something I wanted to try out. And I have lost about 20 pounds already. And honestly, I wasn't even sure if I was losing weight or not, because this is really ridiculous, but I don't even have a scale. I need to get one, but I ended up weighing myself at the gym, and I just know how much I weighed starting out. So yeah, it's been nice, and it's been nice to get back into the gym, get out of the house, and to do something for myself. So yeah, but let me know if you do want to hear more about, like, I guess, my personal weight loss and what I'm eating and what I'm doing in the gym and things like that. I mean, I could always add some stuff here and there. I mean, I do like adding grocery hauls and sometimes like little meals or snacks and stuff like thrown into my videos. And I wanted to do some more of that anyway. But yeah, let me know if you want to see some low carb stuff. Wondering what's going on here. I had this tricky stain that I couldn't get out and Dawn dish spray didn't help. So now I'm just using the Method stain remover. I love this thing so much. I just get it off of Grove and it works really well on clothes when I use it on clothes. So I just wanted to try it on there. And honestly, I don't even know if I went back over it with the carpet cleaner. So I can't even show you the after, but I think that's just a tricky stain, and thinking about it, I gotta go back and see if it's still there. I mean, that carpet needs to be shampooed again, also, as I'm sitting here. But yeah, that Method stain remover really, really does work. And then also, because the attachment for the carpet cleaner broke, I didn't even get to do the other couch. I got almost all the way through the smaller couch, and I didn't even get to use it on the bigger couch. So I just went ahead and sprayed it down with that Clorox disinfectant spray and all the pillows and everything before I put the covers back on. But yeah, just forgot to mention that. was already getting pretty late about this time. I think it was already close to 9, and the kids all get into bed about 9, so I had to do bedtime a little bit after this. But I had been going, I think, all day since before the kids got home, and one had actually stayed home because she had a doctor's appointment, and then, yeah, all the kids running around after, and then there's another one because it's almost bedtime. And yeah, so then I think I just finished with the microwave, and then the next day I get started on pulling everything out and getting behind the fridge and the stove and all that. Or actually, gotta get on top of the stove cleaned first so that tomorrow I can get started behind it. And yeah. Replaced my scrub mommy, and I'm just going to use the old one to clean the stove with. I think I cleaned the inside of the oven with it too, but yeah, so it's not the same sponge that I'm going to be using on the dishes. Just thought I'd add that in there so no one freaks out.
Oh,
So I'm not using like a heavy duty oven cleaner to clean the oven. I have before and I don't have like a real problem with using them or anything, but I just feel like it, the ones that I've used anyway, and I've just used the basic ones like from the dollar store or Walmart to just, I don't even know the names or the brands, but I just don't feel like they actually do anything different than the Dawn dish spray does. Like, they don't actually cut, well, not that they don't cut the grease, but like, you know, like the black burnt on stains that you have to like really scrub off. I don't think that they get them off any easier. I don't know. I mean, I don't know. You know what I mean? So yeah, I just feel like you got to put the elbow grease in. Anyway, I mean, it just depends on the stain and the cleaner, but the Dawn dish spray really does do the work. And I did use the baking soda cream cleanser in the oven once, but it left behind like some of the baking soda, I guess, or like, you know, some white spots. And I just don't think that I'll be using it in there again. But I mean, the Dawn dish spray has been doing what I need it to do for the oven. I think it works pretty well. But with any type of cleaner I use in the oven, I do try to go back over and like rinse it off. So I do get a wet dishcloth or whatever I'm using, and I try to go back over it and try to get any of the residue off, because obviously you'll be turning the oven on and you don't want any of that stuff to like fume into your food or burn or, you know. So I do that. And there's Christian. He's been, or he was, getting into the fridge a lot. So we've gone, well, we went through, we're on our second fridge baby proofer. I don't know what else to call them, but the, you know, the toddler proofing things. So we had one on there, and then it wasn't like the, I don't know, it was from Walmart, and it just had like these two ribbons, I guess, that went on either side. And so I guess technically you could open it from either side, but I don't know. It didn't work out. One side, the ribbon had come out. And I guess when we went to try to put it back or take it off to fix it, it broke. So anyway, the one that we have now is from Amazon. It's not in this video, but I'll link it down in the description in case you're looking for a good one. Or for a fridge like this, and it just kind of sits in the front on both of the doors and holds it closed, and then you just push the bottom up and it kind of releases this. I'm just not able to explain things today, but it just kind of like lifts up so that you can open the doors, I guess, and he can't get in, and it doesn't seem like it'll break. It's working for now, but yeah, I got it off of Amazon. Thank you. Okay, so when I took the shower curtain down, I actually took both of the shower curtains, like the clear one. I took both of them down and I threw them both in the washing machine and it cleaned it really well. I didn't put it in the dryer just because of the heat and I didn't think it really needed to be dried. I mean, it goes on the inside of the shower and gets wet anyway, but washing it in there really got rid of like the soap scum and all of that. So it really did clean it and then it left like the laundry detergent smell on it. Like it held it really well. So the bathroom smelled really good for a while. And yeah, I highly recommend just throwing them in the washer, both of them. And this is just a mop from the Dollar Tree. It comes in separate parts, like you have to buy the stick and then the bottom part and then the what do you call those things? The mop part that sticks to the bottom, because they have different kinds. And I just grabbed that and still it was like under $5 for the whole thing, but it's really nifty. And it's a good little hack to clean mirrors, or I've even used it to clean the walls, or obviously like the ceiling. There's been splatters in the kitchen on the ceiling and I can get it up there. So yeah, that's a nice little hack and you can find it at the Dollar Tree. This right here was actually an amazing combo for the tub. It's a magic eraser, and then that, I don't remember the name of it now, but you saw it, I showed it. yeah, that cleaner just worked really well. It turns white after, I mean, you let it sit there for that amount of time, and I was still cleaning the toilet, so I let that sit on there. But using the magic eraser, like, really got everything nice and shiny. It was, like, really, really shiny afterwards. Thank you. The bath toys always get a little like soap scummy, so I just stuck them in here with really, really hot water and sprayed some of that bleach in there. I let them sit, then rinsed them off, and then stuck them back in the tub. And now I have a little basket that I stuck them in that just stays there in the tub. And yeah, of course, water got everywhere and all over me, so I'm just wiping it up with a towel. But thank you guys so much for watching this video. And if you have been watching my videos and you come back and you're waiting for new ones, I really, really appreciate you. And let me know in the comments if you've been here since my very first video. And as always, you can always let me know what you want to see next. But yeah, thank you guys so, so much. It means so much to me that you come back and watch my videos, or even if you just came across my video and then you watched this one to the end. But I hope you guys have a good rest of your day, good rest of the week.